Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. And today we are going to study about anti-amoebic and anthelmintic drugs. So this is a topic of pharmaceutical chemistry too, and we are starting a new chapter. As the name suggests, anti-amoebic and anti-helminthic or anthelmintic. So these are used in amoebiasis as well as helminthiasis. So to understand in a better way, the anti-amoebic and anti-helminthic drugs or anthelmintic drugs. So we need to know that what is amoebiasis as well as what is helminthiasis, and which kind of disease is those, and what are the signs and symptoms of this disease, when this kind of disease can occur, and how we can manage these disease conditions. So in terms of amoebiasis, the first point, it is a parasitic infection of colon. It means it is caused by a parasite. Okay, so parasites are generally those microorganisms which are having a special kind of properties that they absorb nutrition value from the other host. So if we are the host, the organism will accept the nutrition from our body. Those are known as parasite. So it is also known as amoebic dysentery. Generally, it is formed in a dysentery form whether there is a loss of water from our body. Symptoms are most common during the infection by Entamoeba histolytica. So the organism responsible for amoebiasis is Entamoeba histolytica. We have seen the other organism for other bacterial infection also, or viral infection also, but this is a protozoal infection which are caused by the protozoa named Entamoeba histolytica. Symptoms generally diarrhea, bloody stools or fever. Diarrhea are most common for the amoebiasis. Generally diarrhea, there are various types of diarrhea, but the diarrhea for the amoebiasis is very special, and it comes with the abdominal cramps also. Mainly transmitted via orofecal route. Orofecal routes means when the protozoal infection spread from the fecal or fecus or feces of the other organism or other animal through the consumption of through our meal. Suppose we are having something or we are drinking something which is contaminated through this Entamoeba histolytica organism, then it can cause this amoebiasis infection. So now it's time for helminthiasis. So helminthiasis is the infection where helminth are present. So it is also known as worm infection. So this is a various kind of infection. Worm, it contains the tapeworm as well as the roundworm. It is a major health issue in tropical and subtropical and lower income countries. So see, where the climatic condition is more severe, and the heater area or hot region along with the below poverty level, and most of the people are facing this helminthiasis problem. Generally the worm responsible for the helminthiasis disease condition are generally roundworms, mainly known as Ascaris lumbricoides. So this is the organism or roundworms in responsible for helminthiasis. The organism responsible for amoebiasis is Entamoeba histolytica, and the organism responsible for helminthiasis is Ascaris lumbricoides. You have to remember that. Question may comes as a short term. So along with this roundworm, there are other kind of worms like hookworms or tapeworms. So these are the, as a known as a collective matter, this is known as the worm infection. Helminthiasis also known as worm infection. So as we have seen that the amoebiasis or amoebic dysentery disease spread from orofecal route, and this is also terms or also spread from the soil or water or contaminated foods by having or by nearing to that. So worm can comes to your body and it will it will grow in your body and it will infect to your organs. The organs may be your GI tract or maybe some other responsible organ for your total physical management. It we comes for the anti-MOB class, drugs classification. The, generally, they are classified according to the uses. According to the uses or the organ they are used for. If the amoebiasis or amoebic dysentery caused in the luminal area of your pancreas, then the anti-amoebic drugs will be classified as luminal anti-amoebic drugs or luminal amoebocides. Okay, so the this is the useful drugs for the treatment of intestine and lumen. In terms of use, example of drugs, we have iodoquinol, paromycin, panobomycin, and diloxanide puroid. Okay, so these are the some drugs generally useful for luminal and as used as luminal anti-amoebic drugs. Next, the classes of drugs, that is systemic anti-amoebic drugs. Systemic anti-amoebic drugs means they are generally used for other systemic areas where the blood circulation is more. So these are most vascularized tissues like intestine and liver. So the systemic anti-amoebic drugs or systemic amoebiasis is controlled by the drugs of emetin, that is a natural product used for treatment of amoebiasis. The chloroquine is a hydroxychloroquinol along with the dehydroemetin. So dehydroemetin as well as emetin, those are the natural products, and chloroquinol is also natural products. So next class of drugs is mixed. So these are the useful or effective drugs. They can be used for both the disease condition, either luminal as well as systemic. Whether that amoebiasis is happened in luminal side as well as the amoebiasis occurred in systemic areas, so this kind of drugs you can use at the any time, whether you are properly diagnosed or not, whether you are having the luminal amoebiasis or systemic amoebiasis. The drugs of this class are very useful, like tinidazole and metronidazole. So metronidazole is very useful drugs. You have heard about the metronidazole many a times because it is available in the brand name of Metrogil or Metzil or Flazil. Generally useful for controlling the diarrhea or dysentery condition. In terms of classification of anthelmintic drugs, they are generally classified according to the structure or chemical structure present on those drugs. So the first class of drugs is piperazines. So piperazine is a heterocyclic nucleus having a six-membered heterocyclic nucleus having the two nitrogen in one and fourth position. So the piperazine ring having a very much anti-helminthic drugs, they can coagulate the helminthesis or helminth, that is ascaring lumbricoides protein. The drugs useful for piperazine class are piperazine itself as well, along with diethyl carbamazine. It is also known as DEC. Next class of drugs is benzimidazole. This is again a heterocyclic drugs containing nitrogen. So azoles are heterocyclic drugs containing nitrogen. So benzimidazole is having a fused heterocyclic drugs where the benzene ring is fused with imidazole. Benzene plus imidazole is known as benzimidazole. So drugs of this class are albendazole, mebendazole. They are all having azole at their structure, and the other heterocyclic structure used as anthelmintic drugs are quinolines, isoquinolines. Quinolines like chloroquinine is also useful to control anthelmintic condition. In isoquinoline, we have praziquantel. And the next class of drugs having for anthelmintic controlling the disease controlling condition is the natural product. This is ivermectin. So for anti-emetic drugs also, they are a natural product as emetin, dehydroemetin, and for controlling the anthelmintic condition, they are a natural product, ivermectin. So now comes from the for the individual agent used for anthelmintic condition or disease condition. So we are starting the individual agent today, and in the next class we will see the more individual agent. So emetin is a natural product obtained from the ipecac root. Okay, so brand name of emetin having oprazone, emetina, tolmetin, and dehydroemetin. Dosage form of this emetin class is very much popular as injectables, but along with the injectables, tablet and solution form is also available. Next, in terms of uses, they are used to treat the amoebic dysentery or amoebiasis. Along with that, it is also useful as expectorant to expel the cough out of your lungs or the respiratory tract. For it is also useful for inducing emesis or vomiting. In terms of properties, it is white amorphous powder with bitter taste. Emetin is a bitter alkaloid. Okay. So it is having a very bitter taste like Nux vomica, and having a mass of 480 gram per mole, melting point of very low, that is 74 degree centigrade, and it is soluble in methanol, ethanol, and due to the alkaloid property, it is also slightly soluble in water. But in terms of stability, it turns yellow in light and heat and exposure, and it should be stored in tightly closed container. So students, that's all for today. So today we have learned about the amoebiasis as well as helminthiasis, the condition that the organism responsible for this protozoal infection amoebiasis, as well as the parasitic infection, that is helminthiasis, Ascaris lumbricoides, and we have seen the classification of drugs that are useful for controlling the amoebic dysentery as well as helminthiasis, and at the last we have seen the drugs of choice for anti-amoebic as anti-amoebic drugs, that is emetin, that is obtained from natural product ipecac. So thank you friends, thank you for your time for listening the lecture. Hope you like the video, and if you have any queries regarding the anti-amoebic or anti-helminthic drugs or helminthiasis or amoebiasis, you can pin the comment, and waiting for your response.